In the streets, you know, we bring in a lot of brothers out.
Well, the brothers in the street are willing to work it out. Let's get it on.
Peace. What's up? This is Chuck D of Public Enemy. As we all move into the 90s, rap comes on strong with a message to unite, fight the power, and do not believe the hype. Rap is the CNN of the 90s. It educates, preaches, inspires, and crosses all the cultures. You know, rap is the voice of the youth because they got something to say. Myself with Public Enemy and KRS-One of Boogie Down Productions, they call us the trendsetters of this particular music and style with the message all in the music. So y'all check this out.
Rap is like a setup. A lot of games, a lot of suckers with colorful names. I'm so-and-so, I'm this, I'm that, but they all just wick, wick, whack.
We should never forget that we're still entertainers. It's just, here comes intelligence. Now, whoa, intelligence can sell? I mean, it's like, whoa, can it really?
Fight the power! Fight the power!
When we was with Public Enemy, we first started, and everybody told us, no, you can't talk about anything with any message or any substance. Little did we know that, you know, it would become, you know, as big as it is.
And I'm a black man, and I can never be a veteran. All the sprint of situations unreal, I got a raw deal, so I'm looking for the steal.
People are always looking for something new. Now the thing is, political rap is seems to be the trend or the mainstream right now as far as rap audience goes.
Rap music, from a message side of view, is basically just a reflection on how we living. So, you know, from the black side of things, you know, a young black male or female could say, well, basically, these are my problems, and this is how I like to see things rolling, and this is my point of view towards life, and explain it through rap.
Because we are in war!
I smell a riot going on, fight the power.
Say don't worry, because I won't hurt you. All I really want to do is freak you. You know what?
Rap reflects its culture, and some brothers and sisters are expressing their identification with the motherland, Africa, and creating a popular new look and the sound.
Sending a message to the old and young, confused about where I come from, what planet, what channel, what station, Africa from the Zulu nation.
Our main concern is to be ourselves and continue to do what we've always been doing, and that's hip-hop music and being the great African B-boy.
It exit the old style into the new, but nothing's new by being hawked by a few. Or should I say a flock, because around every block there's Harry, Dick, and Tom with a demo in his demo.
Yeah, and some of these guys are beyond words.
De La Soul is more in the style of changing their words around, making words like a jigsaw puzzle, not simply giving you the words up front so you can know what I'm talking about. You have to listen to my style a couple of times to know where I'm coming from.
Rap music today also has a conscience. Two campaigns, one from the East Coast in 1989, Stop the Violence, and one from the West Coast in 1990, were all in the same gang. Both attempted to raise the consciousness of the youth and did quite well.
When I least show easy's no sellout. And if you can't hang in the streets, then get the hell out. I'm not trying to tell you what to do. You have your own freedom of choice who to listen to.
We should at least be at peace with ourselves before we can be at peace with everybody else.
Now rap's got you covered from every angle. If you don't like hardcore or political rap, there are some rappers who are smoothed out on R&B.
See, with our particular style of music, we can interface with all styles of music. Now it's to the point where now it's like where it was rock when I'm Run DMC, it's now become R&B-ish like, so to speak, with a touch of funk.
Everybody shake your body. We don't feel, we chill at a party.
Or how about a laugh or two?
We used to get dressed up in double knit and the plaid suit jacket.
I tried to make rap break a record. Where no matter what I did, everybody thought it was funny.
It's called
this spring again. Everybody knows spring again.
With the Humpster himself, the most important thing to me in my music is to come with the craziest, sickest, most berserk idea I could come with, but still stay loyal to hip-hop.
Alright, stop what you're doing, cause I'm about to ruin the image and the style that you're used to. I look funny, but yo, I'm making money, see? So yo, world, I hope you're ready for me.
Yeah, that's funny.
And of course, the veteran rappers who continue to evolve and who grow with the time.
Get up! I rise and shine like the sun on the one. We dance together, we overcome.
But that's how it goes down when you're living in the city. No BS allowed.
This is what the industry is all about. It's room for everybody. My opinion, I see where rap going is back to the streets.
Hopefully it goes back to the street and don't get caught up in a bunch of commercial, you know, politics. It keeps going. If it starts getting to that Vanilla Ice and, you know, taking rap way out there, you know, it's going to cross over and then you're going to see rap no more.
My manager thinks, Tommy Kwan thinks I'm the James Dean of rap. I'm like, I'm Vanilla Ice. I'm not anybody, I'm Vanilla Ice.
Yo, man, let's get out of here.
If you want it, you got it.
No one can argue with the success that some brothers have had in the last few years. Rap has broken through to the pop charts, and nowadays, it's not just the street sound appealing only to the hardcore fans.
Baby,
break it down for me, fellas.
Well, one of the strangest things in the rap language is the word or the phrase sellout. What it really means is, why didn't it happen to me?
Can't touch this.
If your record crosses over pop and you get white listeners, Latin listeners, and listeners who are not black, you are quoted or called a sellout. If that's a sellout, then here I am. I'm a sellout because I want my music to be accepted by all people.
They want to do the wild thing.
It's like myself, I went through the same thing that Hammer's going through right now. I mean, you make a hit record, you intended to go for the rap or whatever. I mean, I don't think anybody can plan to cross over or get on the pop charts unless you're specifically a pop artist, but rappers can't. If you want your music to be heard by everybody, the more the merrier. You know what I'm saying? I said, when you start paying my rent and taking care of my kids, then I'll change my music.
Wow, man.
Nobody thought 12 years ago rap would be at the forefront. All forms of music are gonna have to embrace rap, because I always say if Martians could speak, they'd rap. They wouldn't sing, because singing's been here so long, it's common. We need something new. And rapping is like staccato on track.
Here is the dome, back with the bass. Pajamas live in effect, and I don't waste time. On the mic with a dope rhyme. Jump to the rhythm, jump, jump to the rhythm, jump.
The thing that I think that still remains the same, that's the thing that's just so exciting about rap, is that it's still funky and it's still raw. And whether it was with Africa Bambaataa and the Soul Sonic Force, or whether you're talking about De La Soul, it's still funky and raw and fresh.
Exit the old style into the new. Why not is new by being hawked by a few? I should have stayed flocked around every block.
Ho, ho, don't get up. There's more rap.